Sir, am I visible?
ज्योति
Yes, sir.
म्यूट योर माइक।
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, honorable authorities, Dean Sir, Dr. Malay Patel Sir, fellow faculty members, and amicable student friends. It gives me immense pleasure to extend to you all very warm greetings on behalf of United Towards School of Law, Karnavati University. It is my pleasure and privilege to welcome you all to grace this occasion together as a family of UWSL to mark another landmark of success. November 26, 1949 is a red letter day in the history of our constitution. It is the day on which we adopted our constitution, which came into force on 26 January 1950. It is in the memory of that day, since 1979, we are celebrating Samvidhan Divas on 26 November every year. I consider it as a great honor to introduce Professor Dr. Nishtha Jaiswal, who has been appointed as the first woman Vice Chancellor of Himachal Pradesh National Law University, Shimla. A gold medalist and academician, Dr. Nishtha Jaiswal has a teaching experience of 32 years and research experience of 34 years. She specializes in constitutional law, administrative law, human rights, and environmental law. She has over 65 research papers and 6 books to her name. Her book titled Environmental Law has been cited thrice by the Supreme Court of India in the landmark judgment. Professor Nishtha Jaiswal has been designated as Meher Chand Mahajan Professor of Law by the Punjab University, Chandigarh. She has served Punjab University, Chandigarh in various capacities. She remained the chairperson, Department of Laws, Punjab University, Chandigarh. Dr. Nishtha Jaiswal has a wide range of administrative experience. She has served as a member of Chandigarh Commission for Protection of Child Rights, Punjab Legal Service Authority, UT, Chandigarh, State Level Authorization Committee of Punjab under the Transplantation of Human Organs Act, 1994, and Advisory Committee, Nari Niketan, Chandigarh. She is also a member of Board of Studies and Academic Council, CUP Bhatinda, RG Annual Punjab, UILS PU Chandigarh, IMS University Dehradun, HPU Shimla, and KU Kurukshetra. Dr. Nishtha Jaiswal was also awarded British Academy Visiting Professorship in 1992. With your permission, ma'am, we would like to showcase the diversity of student community of UWSL by reciting the preamble in different regional languages.
Sure, beta. Now, God bless.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Now, I would like to recite the preamble in English language. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic, and political liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity as ensuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of our nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact, and give to ourselves this Constitution. Now, I would like to request Jyoti to recite the preamble in Sanskrit language.
भारतस्य संविधानम् प्रस्तावना वयम् भारतस्य जनाः भारतस्य संपूर्ण प्रभुत्व संपन्नम् समाजवादिनम् संप्रदाय निरपेक्षम् लोकतांत्रात्मक गणराज्य विधान्तम् तस्य समस्तान नागरिकांश सामाजिक अर्थवा आर्थिकम् राजनैतिकम् च न्यायम् विचारस्य अधिव्यक्तेयम् अस्थस्याः धर्मस्य उपानस्यश्च स्वतंत्रताम् प्रतिष्ठायाः अवरस्य च समातम् प्रायापिन्तु तेषु सर्वेषु च व्यक्तिगौरवस्य राष्ट्रस्य एकतायाः अखण्डतायाश्च सुनिश्चायाक्या बिन्दुता वृध्यन्तु कृत दृढ़ संकल्पाः आस्याम् अस्मद्यायाम् संविधान सभायाम् अतः कितस्यः नवचतुर् नव एकतमे वर्षे नवंबर मास्याम् सर्वश्रेष्ठ तमे दिने श्रेष्ठ शून्य शून्य दवे तमे विक्रम तंसवरे मार्गशीर्षे शुल्क पक्षे सप्तायाम् तिथो इन्ते इंद संविधान अड़गृत ग्रंथ अधिनियमित आत्म प्रत च कुमरे.
Thank you. Now I would like to request Deependra to recite the preamble in Hindi language.
हम भारत के लोग भारत को एक संप्रभुत्व संपन्न समाजवादी पंथ निरपेक्ष लोकतांत्रात्मक गणराज्य बनाने के लिए तथा उसके समस्त नागरिकों को सामाजिक आर्थिक और राजनीतिक न्याय विचार अभिव्यक्ति विश्वास धर्म और उपासना की स्वतंत्रता प्रतिष्ठा और अवसर की समता प्रदान करने के लिए तथा उन सब में व्यक्तित्व की गरिमा और राष्ट्र की एकता और अखंडता सुनिश्चित करने वाली बंधुता बढ़ाने के लिए दृढ़ संकल्प होकर अपनी इस संविधान सभा में आज तारीख 26 नवंबर 1949 संवत 2006 विक्रमी को इतत संविधान को अंगीकृत अधिनियमित और आत्म समर्पित करते हैं.
Now I would like to request Jinsi to recite the preamble in Gujarati language.
भारत नो संविधान अमुक हमें भारत ना लोको भारत ने एक सार्वभौम समाजवादी बिन सांप्रदायिक लोकतंत्रात्मक प्रजासत्ताक तरीके संस्थापित करवानो तथा तेना सर्व नागरिकों ने सामाजिक आर्थिक अने राजकीय न्याय विचार अभिव्यक्ति मान्यता धर्म अने उपासना ने स्वतंत्रता દરજા અને તકની સમાનતા પ્રાપ્ત થાય તેમ કરવાનો અને તેઓ સર્વમાં વ્યક્તિનો ગૌરવ અને રાષ્ટ્રની એકતા અને અખંડતા સદ્રઢ કરે એવી બંધુતા વિકાસવાનો ગંભીરતાપૂર્વક સંકલ્પ કરીને અમારી સંવિધાન સભામાં 26 નવેમ્બર 1949 ના રોજ આથી આ સંવિધાન અપનાવી તેને અધિનિયમિત કરી અને આપને અમને પોતાને અર્પિત કરીએ છીએ. ધન્યવાદ.
Now I would like to request Manav to recite the preamble in Bengali language.
আমরা ভারতের জনগণ ভারতকে একটি সার্বভৌমা সমাজতান্ত্রিক ধর্মনিরপেক্ষ গণতান্ত্রিক গণরাজ্য এবং এই সমাজটি নাগরিককে সুরক্ষিত করা ন্যায় বিচার সামাজিক অর্থনৈতিক ও রাজনৈতিক চিন্তার প্রকাশ বিশ্বাস বিশ্বাস এবং উপাসনার স্বাধীনতা স্থিতি এবং সুযোগের সমানতা এবং ভ্রাতৃত্ব করি ব্যক্তির মর্যাদা জাতির একতা ও অখণ্ডতা নিশ্চয়তা প্রদান করা তাদের মধ্যে সকল প্রচ্ছন্নতা প্রচার করা আমাদের সংবিধানের অনুসার 1949 সালে এই 26 দিনের দিন এই সংবিধানই এখানে কার্যকর করুন এবং আমাদেরকে প্রদান করুন. ধন্যবাদ.
Now I would like to request Ananya to recite the preamble in Malayalam language.
Indian Dharma Ghatana Amukham. ഒരു പരമധികാര സ്ഥിതി സമത്വ മണിപ്രേക്ഷ ജനപതിയായ റിപ്പബ്ലിക്കായി സംവിധാനം ചെയ്യുന്നതിനും ഇന്നത്തെയിലെ എല്ലാമാർക്കും സാമൂഹികവും സാമ്പത്തികവും രാഷ്ട്രീയവുമായ നീതി ചിന്ത ആശ്വസ്തിവികാരം വിശ്വാസവും ഭക്തി ആരാധന എന്നിവയുള്ള സ്വാസ്ഥര്യം സദാനമങ്ങൾ അവസരങ്ങൾ എന്നിവയുള്ള സമത്വം എന്നിവ ഉറപ്പുവരുത്തുന്നതിനും ഐക്യവും അഖണ്ഡതയും സഹോദരയോരം എല്ലാവരിലും ദൃഢനിശ്ചയം ചെയ്തുകൊണ്ട് നമ്മുടെ ഭരണഘടന സഭയിൽ 1949 26 ദിവസം ഈ ഭരണഘടനയിലെ അമികാരികവുമായ നിയമകയും നമുക്കായിട്ട് സമർപ്പിക്കുവാനും ചെയ്യുന്നു. നമസ്കാരം.
Now I would like to request Hussain to recite the preamble in Urdu language. Hussain, are you there?
भारत का आईन तमहीद. हम भारत के आवाम मतानत व संजीदगी से अज्म करते हैं कि भारत को एक मुक्तदिर समाजवादी गैर मजहबी आवामी जमहूरिया बनाए और इससे और इसके तमाम शहरियों को हासिल करें इंसाफ समाजी माशी और सियासी آزادی خیال اظہار عقیدہ دین اور عبادت مساوات با اعتشار عشت اور موقع اور ان سب میں اقوت کو دین خیر فرد کی عظمت قوم اتحاد اور سلامیت کا توقین کریں اپنی این ایس اسمبلی میں آج 26 نومبر 1949 کو یہ آئین ذریعہ حاضہ اختیار کرتے ہیں واضح کرتے ہیں اور اپنے آپ پر نفس کرتے ہیں.
Thank you. Now I would like to request Disha to recite the preamble in Oriya language.
Bharata Samvidhana ro Prath Kathana. आंबे भारतवासी भारत के एक सर्वभौमो समाजवादी धर्मनिरपेक्षो ગણતાંત્રિક સાધારણતંત્ર રૂપે ગઠન કરવા પે દૃઢ સંકલ્પ ને ઓ એહાર નાગરિકોંકુ સામાજિકો અર્થનૈતિક ઓ રાજનૈતિક ન્યાય એ ચિંતા અભિવ્યક્તિ પ્રત્યય ધર્મ વિશ્વાસ ઉપાસનાર સ્વતંત્રતા સ્થિતિ સુવિધ સુજાગ્ર સમાનતર સુરક્ષા પ્રદાન કરવાકુ તથા વ્યક્તિ મર્જદા એવમ રાષ્ટ્ર એકો અસમર્થ નિશ્ચિત કરે સમાનનકા ભ્રાતૃભાવ ઉશ્ચયતા કરવાકુ એ ઓ 1949 નવેમ્બર ચૌવીસ્યા તારીખ દિન આમોર સંવિધાન પ્રણોત સવારે એ તો દ્વારા એ સંવિધાન કો ગ્રહણ ઓ પ્રણયન કરું છું એવમ આમો નિજો કો અર્પણ કરું છું.
Now I would like to request Arjun to recite the preamble in Punjabi language.
Asi Bhartwasi Bhart nu ik sampurn taur te samajwadi pak nirpekh loktantra raj banaun de layi us de sare nagrikan nu samajik aarthik ate rajneetik nyay vichar nichi vishwas taran ate us di pooja ate pagdi di swatantrata ate ਉਸ ਅਵਸਰ ਤੇ ਸੁਮੇਲਤਾ ਪ੍ਰਾਪਤ ਕਰਨ ਦੇ ਲਈ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਸਭ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਵਿਅਕਤੀ ਦਾ ਮਾਨ ਅਤੇ ਰਾਜਤੀ ਏਕਤਾ ਅਤੇ ਇਕਸਰਤਾ ਨਿਸ਼ਚਿਤ ਕਰਨ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਭਾਈਚਾਰੇ ਨੂੰ ਵਧਾਉਣ ਦੇ ਲਈ ਅਸੀਂ ਦ੍ਰਿੜਵਾਦੀ ਹੋ ਕੇ ਇਸ ਸੰਵਿਧਾਨ ਸਭਾ ਤੇ ਅੱਜ ਤਰੀਕ 26 ਨਵੰਬਰ 1949 ਤੇ ਇਸ ਸੰਵਿਧਾਨ ਨੂੰ ਅਗਨੀਕ੍ਰਿਤ ਅਧਿਨਿਯਮਿਤ ਅਤੇ ਸਮਰਪਿਤ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ.
Now I would like to request Kinjal to recite the preamble in Sindhi language.
Bharat jo samvidhan prastavna asi bharat ja log bharat ke ek sarvagun samajwadi lokit loktantra prajasit tarike sthapna karan jo unje sabin nagrikan ke samajik arthik pravritik nyay vichar varnan vishwas vesh pooja ji swatantrata pad ji vijay ji समानता आए सबनीन में विवेकता जो सौमान राष्ट्र जी एकता अखंडता वधे एडो भाव प्राप्त थिए ते लाए पक्की प्रतिज्ञा करी पंजे संविधान सभा में अज 26 नवंबर 1949 जे डी ए संविधान स्वीकार करियूं ता इनके कानूनी रूप दियूं ता आए पान के अर्पण करियूं ता.
Now I would like to request Manthan to recite the preamble in Marathi language.
आम्ही भारताचे लोक भारताचे सर्वगुण समाजवादी धर्मनिरपेक्ष लोकशाही गणराज्य घडवणे त्याच्या सर्व नागरिकांस सामाजिक आर्थिक व राजनैतिक न्याय विचार अभिव्यक्ति विश्वास श्रद्धा व उपासना यांचे स्वातंत्र्य दर्जाची व संधीची समानता निश्चितपणे प्राप्त करून देण्याचा आणि त्या सर्व मध्य व्यक्ति की प्रतिष्ठा व राष्ट्र की एकता आणि एकात्मा यांचे आश्वासन देणारी बंधुता प्रवर्धित करण्याचा संकल्पपूर्वक निर्धार करू आमचे संबंधीनी सभेत आजाद दिन 26 नवंबर 1949 रोजी यद्याये संविधान अंगीकृत आणि अधिनियमित करून स्वतः प्रत अर्पण करीत आहोत.
Now I would like to request Mitali to recite the preamble in Nepali language.
Hami Bharat ka jadata Bharat lai euta sampurna prabhutva sampanna samajwadi panth nirpeksh lok tantratmak ganrajya banav ko lagi tatha yasaka samast nagrika samajik arthik ani rajnaitik nyay vichar abhivyakti vishwas ધર્મ અને ઉપાસનાઓ કો સ્વતંત્રતા પ્રતિષ્ઠા અને અવસરો કો સમાનતા પ્રાપ્ત ગણનાઓ કો લાગી તથા તી સબમાં વ્યક્તિઓ કો ગરિમા અને રાષ્ટ્રો કો એકતા અને અખંડતા સુનિશ્ચિત ગણને બંધુતા બઢનાઓ કો લાગી દ્રઢ સંકલ્પ વર્ણ અપનાવ ય સંવિધાન સભામાં આજ તારીખ 26 નવેમ્બર 1949 ઈ મિતિ માર્કશીક સ્કૂલ સપ્તમી સંવત 2006 વિક્રમી માં એતદ દ્વારા ય સંવિધાન લાઈ અંગ્રેજ અધ્યાનિમિત અને આત્મપ્રેરિત ગરદચ્છો. ધન્યવાદ.
થેન્ક યુ સો મચ ઓલ માય ડિયર સ્ટુડન્ટ્સ. નાઉ આઈ વુડ લાઈક ટુ રિક્વેસ્ટ પ્રોફેસર ડોક્ટર નિષ્ઠા જયસ્વાલ ટુ એનલાઇટન ધ સ્ટુડન્ટ્સ.
Thank you, Beta. And it's really wonderful. Nishtha inviting Nishtha. So I'll follow your steps. It's always good to follow the children. Now you have recited in different languages, and I must share with you that I'm a poet by heart. So I am reciting in my own poetry, preamble only. Satyanishtha se kiya sankalp. Satyanishtha se kiya sankalp hum Bharat ke jan jan ne. Satyanishtha se kiya sankalp hum Bharat ke jan jan ne. Bharat mein samprabhuta, samajwad, dharam nirpeshta, loktantratmak ganrajya sthapit karne. सिंहासन होगा सामाजिक राजनीतिक आर्थिक न्याय को सिंहासन होगा सामाजिक आर्थिक राजनीतिक न्याय को स्वतंत्रता होगी विचार अभिव्यक्ति धारणा आस्था धर्म उपासना दिन रात सुबह साय को प्रतिष्ठा और अवसर होंगे समानता की कसौटी होगी प्रतिष्ठा और होंगे समानता की कसौटी होगी व्यक्ति की गरिमा राष्ट्र की एकता और अखंडता बंधुता से सुनिश्चित होगी दृढ़ संकल्प कर संविधान सभा ने 1949 में आज के दिन किया निश्चित दृढ़ संकल्प कर संविधान सभा ने 1949 में आज किया निश्चित इस संविधान को करने अंगीकृत अधिनियमित और आत्मसमर्पित Now, as promised on this Constitution Day, when we enacted, adopted, and gave to ourselves this Constitution, I'll start with the last shloka of Rigveda, which is also known as Sangathan Shloka. It says, समानी व आकुति समाना हृदयानि व समानमस्तु वो मना यथा व सुसहा सति यथा व सुसहा असति इट्स अ ग्रेट मीनिंग सेज लेट योर कंक्लूजन्स बी वन लेट योर हार्ट्स बी द सेम लेट योर माइंड्स थिंक अलाइक मे ऑल दीज फैक्टर्स मेक योर ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल पावर एन इम्प्रेसिव वन नाउ इफ यू वांट A nation to be an organizational power, an impressive power, then we have this constitution. The most sacred document, the holy book. Before I start my journey, from the day we adopted, enacted, and gave to ourselves this constitution, starting from 1950, I would like to proceed on certain premise. All of us agree, Constitution of India is the fundamental law of the land. It is a grand naam if you go by Kelsen's norm theory. It is a living and a dynamic document. The Supreme Court has talked about transformative constitutionalism. And because of transformative constitutionalism, we are ready to transform this constitution also. That is why we call it as a living and dynamic document. We are very lucky. We can talk about constitution, constitutional law, and constitutionalism. Rule of law runs like a golden thread under the constitution. We can talk on the touchstone of the World Justice Project Rule of Law Index Report. Even 2020. Separation of powers is not an integral part of the constitution, but we believe in theory of checks and balances. Judiciary, we don't say is this most supreme. All the three organs of the state, they're equal, having autonomy, but keeping in view the theory of checks and balances, of course, judiciary has the power of judicial review or to interpret the constitution. We, the people of India, have given to ourselves. Now, when we start with the preamble, we say, we, the people of India, having solemnly resolved. Solemnly means with great wisdom, we resolved. It was not forced upon us. It's an outcome of political agreement. See, must learn. I would not say respect, merely worship this holy book. Take it as our national religion. We keep on criticizing on one account or the other, but we must understand the values of the Constitution. No structure can stay unless and until pillars are there. Constitution also survives. It will not collapse because there are very, very important pillars, four pillars mainly. Democracy, secular form of government, secular ideology, sovereignty of the people. And if we want to go by the structure, now we can talk about all the important concepts which are enshrined under the preamble. You read a number of times, so I'll not repeat, like sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, and so on. We are citizens of this country. This country, only under Article 1, we find a reference to the name Bharat. Citizenship, we find to reference Articles 5 to 11, Fundamental Rights in Part 3 of the Constitution. Rector principles in part 4 of the Constitution. I always appreciate Article 37 and 38. 37, which makes rector principles fundamental in the governance of the country. 38, which ensures socio-economic justice. Fundamental duties added by 42nd Amendment Act part 4A was at the Article 51A. Not going in much detail about the structure, we know three organs, we find it is their functions, powers, not only the three organs, executive, legislature, and judiciary, but also we talk about local self-governance in the form of panchayats, municipalities, cooperative societies. Now, we are a democracy, so elections have to take place. We have the provisions for elections, election commission. Now, the government has to run. So we have the provisions for safeguards in favor of civil servants, Article 309, 10, and 11. We are ready for all kind of emergencies. We have emergency provisions too. Article 352 to 360. As I said, Constitution is a living and dynamic document. No law can be static. It has to be dynamic. So we have Article 368, power and procedure to amend the Constitution. Even though we have done away with Article 370, giving special status to state of J&K. Still, we talk about temporary, transitional, and special provisions. Number of schedules, lengthiest 12 schedules, 25 parts, lengthiest constitution. If you come to working of the constitution, the first phase we start from 1950 will pass on up to 1967. That was the time when restrictive interpretation was given to the constitution and parliament had dominance. Socialism was a need of the time. Agrarian reforms were introduced. There were conflicts because of property rights. Issues of compensation were discussed by the courts. Article 31A, 31B, 9th schedule were added by First Amendment Act. And power of the parliament to amend the constitution, including fundamental rights, was recognized. I can refer to Shankari Prasad of 1951 and Sajjan Singh of 1965. Restricted interpretation. Now, if we just read A.K. Gopalan versus State of Madras of 1950, law was interpreted as only enacted law. Nowhere mentioned that it will have rule of law or principles of natural justice. We had to travel a lot. I'll be reaching that situation. And that was the time there was so many imposition of president rule in states, and it was so frequently. And then I am not talking about how the governments kept on changing. One party came to rule, another party came into rule, but then passing on to phase two, 1967 to 1977. Judiciary made efforts to re-dominate, and the legislature and the executive had to struggle to re-establish their supremacy. That was the time when Golaknath versus State of Punjab was decided in 1967, limiting the power of parliament to amend the constitution. R.C. Cooper versus Union of India. bank nationalized. 14 banks are nationalized, which was quashed by the Supreme Court. We had so many amendments, 24th to 30th amendment, addition of Article 31C, showing supremacy of directive principles under Article 39B and C over Article 14, 19, and 31. And Article 368 as well, 13 were amended. Then we talk about very, very important development through Keshavananda Bharati versus State of Kerala, where the Supreme Court innovated basic structure theory. That was the time we had the shock. Justice Ray was appointed as Chief Justice, superseding three senior most judges of the Supreme Court, Justice Shellett, Justice Hegde, and Justice Grover. Till then, we had been interpreting right to equality as containing no discrimination principle, concept of reasonable classification. Then came E.P. Royappa versus State of Tamil Nadu in 1974. Right to equality is antithetic to arbitrariness. So if the executive, if the administration exercised power, took any decision arbitrarily, then it could be questioned on the touchstone of Article 14. Arbitrary exercise of power. Now, when we talk about anti-arbitrariness, we refer to rule of law. And rule of law found a living abode under Article 14 of the Constitution. And there were judgments like Indira Nehru Gandhi versus Raj Narayan, which made the concept of rule of law as well as theory of checks and balances as a living reality. Election of Indira Gandhi, the then Prime Minister, was struck down. Role of the Parliament, there was addition of Article 329A by 39th Amendment Act 1975, declaring election of Prime Minister beyond a challenge. Now, this was ultimately repealed by 44th Amendment Act 1978. We had a very dark political period in the political history, judicial history, legal history, when internal emergency was proclaimed in 1975. And right to enforce fundamental rights was suspended. Black spot on judicial history, if I refer to ADM Jabalpur versus S. Shukla in 1976. Even though we find the term rule of law almost on the all the pages of the judgment, but its spirit was not applied. When in the question was protecting life and personal liberty of the people. No doubt, our constitution has to be dynamic. Till date, 104 amendments are there. This was the period when 42nd Amendment Act was passed in 1976, which is known as a mini constitution. Abortive attempt was made to regain parliamentary supremacy, like amendment of Article 13, 31, C, 74, and 368. Even the basic structure theory, which was a restraint on the power to amend under Article 368, which was also taken by making additions to Article 368. If we talk about the position of the president, we have always been struggling between whether president is a puppet or president can be advisor, a friend, a supervisor, a philosopher. Now, this 42nd Amendment Act merely reduced him to the status of a puppet when it was laid down that president shall be bound by the advice of the Council of Ministers headed by the Prime Minister. That was the time when Janata Party took birth. Morarji Desai was the first non-Congress Prime Minister of India. We enter into third phase, 1978 to 1988. Now, this was the era of judicial activism. I refer to एक एक गोपालन सो वी हैड टू ट्रेवल फ्रॉम नॉर्थ पोल एक एक गोपालन रिस्ट्रिक्टेड इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ लॉ टू द साउथ पोल मेनका गांधी वर्सेस यूनियन ऑफ इंडिया आई कैन शेयर विद यू when the constitution was being framed lot of discussion took place regarding having this article 21 guaranteeing right to life or personal liberty it simply says no person shall be deprived of his life or personal liberty except according to procedure established by law lot of discussion took place at that time whether to adopt american due process clause But finally, the words procedure established by law was incorporated. Perhaps there was a fear in the minds of the framers of the Constitution that now the state is a welfare state. And if we have this due process clause, then every interaction between the state and the individual, because once the state is a welfare state, the citizens, the individuals, expectations increase and with the increase in expectation there will be litigation and every act every decision of the state will be tested on the touchstone of fairness justness and reasonableness so they adopted the term procedure established by law it was for the first time in Menaka Gandhi what we rejected we imported American procedural due process that procedure for depriving a person of his life or personal liberty must be fair, just and reasonable. It took another 5 years, Mitthu versus State of Punjab in 1983, where we also imported substantive due process. That is not only the procedure, but also the law has to be fair, just and reasonable. Then came 44th Amendment Act 1978 and the maximum aspect maximum changes which were made by 42nd Amendment Act 1976 were undone. Now, as a consequence of this 44th Amendment Act 1978, right to property was done away with, which was part of Article 19(1)(f) and Article 31. So now after this right to property was no more a fundamental right, only a constitutional right under this was shifted to Article 300A. Then the proviso after Article 74 Clause 2 was added. Now the president can send back the advice given by the Council of Ministers once only. If second time it is sent, then he is bound. Judicial activism was at the top. We can find the birth of public interest litigation. The concept of locus standi was relaxed. In fact, we have, if we refer to constitutional remedies, Article 32 or Article 226, 5 writs can be issued for the protection of fundamental rights. Now, before this public interest litigation introduction, if there was any relaxation in the concept of locus standi, it was only in case of habeas corpus or covarento. Habeas corpus, if I am wrongly confined, can I file this writ of habeas corpus? Answer is no. So somebody else has to file. Maybe my friend, maybe my relative. Same as in case of covarento, when we question the permanent holding of any public office, I may not be holding that office. I may not be an applicant for that office, still I can question this. But there was liberalization of this concept of locus standi and we adopted this public interest litigation, which was also named as like social action litigation. But Supreme Court always cautioned it should not be publicity interest litigation. Only a person with sufficient interest in public matter, then this public interest litigation can be filed. Even with the widening of the scope of writ of habeas corpus, the whole of prison jurisprudence was written in Sunil Batra 1 and Sunil Batra 2, 1 in 1978 and 2 in 1980. Now, habeas corpus is not merely to be used for releasing from wrongful confinement, but also for protection of rights of the prisoners. And we carried forward, we have six Hussainara Khatun cases, where we talk about the condition of under trials, that they were languishing in jails for a period more than the period had they been convicted. So the directions were for their release. Environmental matters came into light. If you see 1979, Mandal Commission was appointed to identify OBC. Report was in 1980. Now we can see the turmoil when Mr. V.P. Singh became the Prime Minister and tried to implement this Mandal Commission report. So many young children committed self-immolation. Darkest, I can say that was darkest period which I can remember. Now, judicial supremacy continued when we refer to Minerva Mills case of 1980, where some parts of 42nd Amendment Act were declared as unconstitutional. For elaborating further the scope of Article 21 after Menaka Gandhi's decision, I can refer to Francis Coralie Mullin of 1981 or Asiad Workers case, PUDR versus Union of India of 1982, where the Supreme Court talked about that right to life means right to live with human dignity. Now, that was the time when we had the first judge's case, S.P. Gupta. And now they have started a shift of appointment of judges, this power in the hands of judiciary. This is the transit period where we had to cross the threshold. And that was the time we talked about accountability of executive authorities. I am referring to Rudrul Shah of 1982, where the person was kept in prison 14 years after he was supposed to be released. Contention on the part of the government was he became insane. That is why he was not released. But the truth is that he became insane because he was kept in jail for 14 years. Bonded labor. Now we have Articles 23, 24, where we talk about no exploitation. 23, no begar, no forced labor. Still, bonded labor existed. And Bandhua Mukti Morcha, Neeraja Chaudhary of 1984, finding out who are the bonded labor, releasing them, rehabilitating them. 1984 witnessed two tragedies. One was Blue Star Operation, followed by assassination of Indira Gandhi, and Bhopal gas tragedy in 1984. Contribution in the year 1984. That was the time when people coming from abroad used to adopt children, poor children from India, and used to exploit them like anything. Came the case of Lakshmikant Pandey versus Union of India in 1984, where the Supreme Court issued inter-country adoption guidelines. I must share with you. Supreme Court issued guidelines in 1984, and the efforts, the CARA guidelines came in 2016. Imagine, after 32 years. That was the time when Shah Banu Begum was decided in 1985. Victim of triple talaq, question of maintenance, settled by the Supreme Court. 1985, 52nd Amendment Act was passed and 10th schedule was added, which provided anti-defection law, which was need of the time. And Administrative Tribunals Act was also passed in 1985. The objective was to make speedy justice a reality, to remove the arrears of cases before the Supreme Court, to have specialized decisions. Apart from administrative tribunal, we can talk about number of other tribunals, industrial tribunals, income tax tribunals, and whatnot. Then came into force Environment Protection Act 1986. Now we had started talking about right to live in healthy environment as a part and parcel of right to life. Then we entered into fourth phase, 1989 to 1996. Now here, that was the time when Mandal Commission was implemented. And after that came the case of Indira Sani. Indira Sani, where the Supreme Court talked about horizontal reservation, vertical reservation, quantitative limitation of 50%, qualitative limitation of removing the creamy layer. Supreme Court clearly said, apart from other directions, no reservation in promotions for backward classes, not for the SC or ST. In spite of that, in 1995, 77th Amendment Act was passed and Article 16, Clause 4A was added, providing for reservations in promotions. And that was the period 1993 when we have 73rd and 74th Amendments providing for the 11th and 12th Schedule, Panchayats and Municipalities. 1993 came the second judge's case, Supreme Court Advocate on Record Association versus Union of India. For the first time, supremacy was given to the Chief Justice and two other judges in making appointments of the judges of the High Court and the Supreme Court. That was the time. On the issues of reservation, Supreme Court again played a positive role in R.K. Sabharwal as well as Ajit Singh Janjua cases in 1995, and they laid down a catch-up formula on a seniority. Then we enter the phase 5. 1996 to 2004. Now, in this time, I want to remind you once again, 1985, we had Administrative Tribunal Act. 1987 came the SP Sampath Kumar's case, where in question was constitutionality. When the question was, because some of the provisions, especially Section 28, took away the power of the High Court, Administrative Tribunal was taken as a substitute of the High Court, taking it as alternative effective institutional mechanism. Now, this whole controversy was laid to rest in L. Chandra Kumar versus Union of India in 1997, where judicial review was taken as a basic structure of the Constitution. Article 323A, 2D, and 323B, 3D were declared unconstitutional because they took away the power of the High Court as well as the Supreme Court. 97 D.K. Basu guidelines emerged. Now, wonderful example of judicial legislation. And it took years to incorporate those guidelines in the Criminal Procedure Code. Vishakha is a marvelous example of, again, judicial legislation in the year 1997, where the Supreme Court issued directions for the protection of women from sexual harassment at workplace. Again, it's really painful if I tell you, 1997 Vishakha's judgment came and the law was passed in 2013, which came into force in December 2013. Then 1999 came the re-presidential reference, now innovating again judicial legislation, innovating a concept of collegium for making appointments of the judges of the High Court as well as the judges of the Supreme Court, are transferring the judges from one High Court to another High Court. We don't find any reference of collegium if we refer to Article 124. Now, this was the time when we had 86th Amendment Act 2002. Even though right to education had become a fundamental right by way of judicial interpretation in 1993 by the decision of Unni Krishnan versus State of Andhra Pradesh, but here specifically legislative role, role of the parliament, Article 21A was added, 11th duty was added in Article 51A, and Article 45, which is a director principle of state policy, was also amended. Then came 91st Amendment Act 2003, which provided for the strength limitation on the Council of Ministers. So Articles 75 and 164 were amended. We enter sixth phase, 2004 to 2014. 93rd Amendment Act 2005, which was made, which added Article 15 Clause 5, reservation in admissions for OBC and SCST. Now, this was to undo what was laid down in PA in Amdar in 2005. Then 97th Amendment Act 2011, Part 9B, dealing with cooperative societies was added. Very, very important judgment came in 2006, M. Nagaraj versus Union of India on the issue of reservation. 77th, 81st, 82nd, 85th amendments, all which amended 16, 4A was added, 4A further added by 85th amendment, consequential seniority thereof for ending the catch-up of formula, as well as amending, adding 16.4b and amending Article 335. All were declared as constitutional in M. Nagaraj. M. Nagaraj Supreme Court gave width test and identity test. Width test was qualitative limitation on reservation, remove the gray layer. Quantitative limitation, not to exceed 50%. Compelling reasons, number one, backwardness. Number two, adequate representation in services. Now, we had been questioning till date. I'll be coming to that after that. I can share here only. And we had those cases, Surajbhan Meena of 2011, or UP Power Corporation versus Rajesh Kumar of 2012, BK Pavitra of 2017, then coming to Jarnail Singh's case, now recent cases of Mukesh Kumar or Beer Singh. All these cases are the Supreme Court questioning that the government has to determine whether they have adequate representation in services or not. How can we forget IR Coelho of 2007? Even if any law is placed in the 9th schedule, it is still subject to judicial review on the ground of violation of basic structure of the constitution. Then the phase which we are in, 2014 onwards. The present government came into rule in 2014 only. Narendra Modi became prime minister. 2014 saw very, very important judgment on gender identity. National Legal Service Authority versus Union of India, where rights of third genders, their identity was recognized, taken as weaker sections, making reservation for them. Then came 99th Amendment Act 2014, and NJAC Act passed. Now this was declared unconstitutional on the ground of violation of very, very important principle of independence of judiciary in Advocates on Record Association versus Union of India in 2015. GST came into force in 2017. There was demonetization in 2016. 2017 saw the journey from Shah Banu to Shaira Banu and triple talaq was declared as unconstitutional. Right to privacy as a fundamental right was confirmed in Justice K.S. Puttaswamy versus Union of India on 24th August 2017. No doubt we had been struggling with this starting from Kharak Singh's case in 1963. Then 102nd Amendment Act 2018, there was deletion of National Backward Classes Commission. Question of position of Lieutenant Governor vis-a-vis Council of Ministers, we had the decision of State versus Union of India in 2018. Aadhaar Act was declared valid in Justice K.S. Puttaswamy on 26th September 2018. I have already talked about all Jarnail Singh and all these cases. After Aruna Ram Chandra Shanbhags of 2010, then came the case of Common Cause versus Union of India in 2018. Where passive euthanasia was held valid and Supreme Court said right to die with human dignity is part and parcel of right to life. How can we forget Navtej Singh Johar, where Section 377 of IPC was declared unconstitutional? Swapnil Tripathi, another decision by the Supreme Court in 2019. Where we talk about the issues of good governance, that Supreme Court proceedings will be live streamed. And due to COVID-19 pandemic crisis, we can see courts are working through video conferencing. Joseph Schein, how can we forget Joseph Schein? Section 497 of IPC, dealing with adultery declared unconstitutional. 2019, Virender Kumar versus State of Himachal Pradesh, where they talked about prospective overruling. I must tell you, this concept of prospective overruling was always there when we talked in Golaknath's case or in Baburam versus Jacob 1999 or Ashok Kumar Gupta of 1997. No. In fact, we are proceeding with all the developments. If I just refer to now coming to the year 2019 only, 103rd Amendment Act, 104th Amendment Act. Till date, we have 104 amendments. 103rd Amendment Act provided for 10% reservation for economically weaker sections. They prescribed what is meant by economically weaker sections. 104th Amendment, 2014, it extends the deadline for the cessation for the reservation of seats for members from SC, ST in the Lok Sabha and legislative assemblies. Now, if we come to 2020, even though we don't like this year, we want this year should pass as soon as possible because of COVID-19 pandemic crisis. But judicial contribution has been there. I can refer to Anuradha Bhasin, Bhasin Union of India. Right to internet was taken as a fundamental right. And this is for the first time the Supreme Court adopted from the American jurisprudence the concept of chilling effect in the light. Because how many people are affected by this cessation of use of internet? On that basis, the decision was ultimately taken. And at the same time, I am full of appreciation in 2020 if I refer it to Babita Punia's case, where Supreme Court said even women in the army has a right to be permanently commissioned in the army. Now, we have to look into ourselves in introspection, what we have gained, why we lost, maybe due to time and again interfering in the constitution, so many amendments which we might not have needed at all. So we have to decide between nationalism and patriotism, secularism and religious freedom, privacy versus security of the country or national interest, animal rights versus individual rights. I am referring to Jallikattu's case. And in fact, the present changes where we talk about the constitutional morality concept. This is new innovation. But I doubt that this is something new in the constitution. Even we say we find place after the Sabarimala issue or Joseph Shine's case, adultery, or Navdev Singh Johar's case, homosexuals issue of homosexuals. But if we know the meaning of morality, it means distinguish between right and good, right and wrong, good and bad. What is constitutional morality? Again, we have to decide between the soul of the constitution, whether it has been rightly adopted or wrongly adopted. Now, whatever I have discussed, if I just again refer to traveling from A.K. Gopalan to Menaka Gandhi, Menaka Gandhi, we started talking about fairness. If I again refer to Vishakha's case, if I talk about that our constitutional faith has to be maintained with logic and rationality. Now, this doctrine was in fact given by George Grote in the 19th century's book, History of Greece. Even Ambedkar talked about this constitutional morality during the framing of the constitution. Now, constitutional morality, Justice Deepak Mishra, who was Chief Justice of India at that time, he also talked about in his judgment and said that magnitude and sweep of constitutional morality is not confined to the provisions and the literal text which a constitution contains. Rather, it embraces within itself a virtue of a wider magnitude that ushers in a pluralistic and inclusive society. Even in Navdev Singh Johar, the Supreme Court talked about the concept of constitutional morality is not limited to the mere observance of the core principle of constitutionalism as the magnitude and sweep of constitutional morality. In fact, the result of embodying constitutional morality is that the values of constitutionalism trickle down and percolate through the apparatus of the state for the betterment of each individual. We may give any name. We may talk about fairness, reasonable justness, or we may talk about constitutional morality. I'm just reminded of Shakespeare when he's asked, through one of his characters, what's in a name? Whether the rose will smell differently if we give rose another name. It's not. You may call me not as Nishtha, by some other name, but I'll remain the same. My personality remains the same. I can simply say, long live the Constitution. And finally, I'll just explain the Constitution in my own words. As I informed you earlier also, I'm a poet by heart. Kon kehta hai kuch panne hai samvidhan? Kon kehta hai kuch panne hai samvidhan? Mera Rab, mera Dharm, mera Astitva hai samvidhan. Vidhi Veta lekhakon ne kalam se jaap kiya iske mantron ka. Vidhi Veta lekhakon ne kalam se jaap kiya iske mantron ka. Magar kathin hai anuman lagana iske tantron ka. Iske phailav ka koi sani nahi jahan mein. Lengthiest constitution. Iske phailav ka koi sani nahi jahan mein. Sanja karna achhai dusron ki nahi aata gunah mein. If we have borrowed some good provisions from other constitution, it's not a blunder. Nagrikta sambhal daro diwar ka banata hai malik. We talk about citizenship. We talk about the extending or changing the boundaries, the territory. Rajya ke teen ango ki swadhinta ke samanvay mein se karata hai waqif. Nagrikta sambhal daro diwar ka banata hai malik. Rajya ke teen ango ki swadhinta ko samanvay mein कराता है वाकिफ. नागरिक होने के हक और व्यक्ति होने का एहसास दिलाता है. सम ऑफ द फंडामेंटल्स आर एनश्राइंड ओनली टू सिटीजंस, सम आर अवेलेबल टू ऑल. वी यूज द टर्म पर्सन. नागरिक होने के हक और व्यक्ति होने का एहसास दिलाता है. मौलिक अधिकारों के दायरे में प्रभुता और शक्ति बंधाता है. समानता के तराजू में समान स्तर पे ही तोलता है. Equals have to be treated equally. समानता के तराजू पे समान स्तर पे ही तोलता है. स्वतंत्रता के सागर को 19वीं धारा की गागर में घोलता है. अपराधी ना रहे बिछी है न्याय की बिसात. अपराधी ना रहे बिछी है न्याय की बिसात. अन्याय ना हो किसी मासूम से, सुरक्षित है उसकी भी औकात. आर्टिकल 20. जीने का अधिकार. जीने का अधिकार यज्ञ अग्नि सज रहा है जल. जीने का अधिकार यज्ञ अग्नि सा रहा है जल. यू नेम एनी राइट अंडर द स्काई दैट इज पार्ट एंड पार्सल ऑफ आर्टिकल 21. सर्वोच्च न्यायालय की मेहरबानियां, सर्वोच्च न्यायालय की मेहरबानियां. अधिकार अनेकों बहते हैं कल कल. अनुचित हिरासत व निरोध का करता है विरोध. आर्टिकल 22. अनुचित हिरासत व निरोध का करता है विरोध. नर नार बाल शोषण का है स्पष्ट अवरोध. आर्टिकल 23 एंड 24. अल्पसंख्यक माइनॉरिटी, अल्पसंख्यक अनुसूचित जातियों जनजातियों का विभाजन घातक सा लगता है मगर एकता अखंडता का है वरदान. हक का दर्द बहुत गहरा बताते हैं उपचार. हक का दर्द बहुत गहरा बताते हैं उपचार. बंदी प्रत्यक्षीकरण हैबियस कॉर्पस, परमादेश मैंडमस, प्रतिषेध प्रोहिबिशन, अधिकार पृच्छा कोवरेंटो और उत्प्रेषण प्रोहिबिशन सर्सररी का है व्यवहार. हक की मृग तृष्णा में कर्तव्य क्यों भुलाता है बंदे. हक की मृग तृष्णा में कर्तव्य क्यों भुलाता है बंदे. तेरे हकों की अदायगी में है मेरे अधिकार बंदे. फंडामेंटल ड्यूटीज. दायित्व है सरकार का सामाजिक आर्थिक न्याय जीवंत करने को. दायित्व है सरकार का सामाजिक आर्थिक न्याय जीवंत करने को. निर्देशक सिद्धांत है डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स. निर्देशक सिद्धांत है मानवीय दुखों का अंत करने को. स्थिर है चाहे संविधान की प्रकृति. स्थिर है चाहे संविधान की प्रकृति मगर जरिया है बदलने को इसकी प्रवृत्ति. इसके अंशों अनुसूचियों में बसा है भारत का भाग्य गहरा. इसके अंशों अनुसूचियों में बसा है भारत का भाग्य गहरा. संशोधन पे बुनियादी संरचना बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर. संशोधन पे बुनियादी संरचना का लगा दिया है पहरा. प्रभुता को बनाता है ये साकार, प्रभुता को बनाता है ये साकार, आपात से जूझने को भी है तैयार, आपात से जूझने को भी है तैयार, इमरजेंसी प्रोविजंस, एंड फाइनली अ प्रेयर टू गॉड, ए रब तेरे बाद गर आशिकी की तो इस देश से, ए रब तेरे बाद गर आशिकी की तो इस देश से, बहुत गर्वित हूं, बहुत गर्वित हूं इस संविधानिक परिवेश से, बहुत गर्वित हूं इस संविधानिक परिवेश से. थैंक यू. सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिना. गॉड ब्लेस ऑल ऑफ अस.
We are honored by your presence on this occasion, ma'am. Thank you so much for your enlightening words. Your thoughts have enlightened our minds and have shown us a new path. Today, we had an opportunity to hear your thoughts, and this will surely be going to encourage us in our future events. Now, my dear students, we will have a short quiz in the form of rapid fire round. So I will be asking you the questions and let us see who will answer it. So the person who will answer first will be the person who will win this quiz competition. Okay, so the first question is, what do you mean by the word masawat? Can anyone tell me, any of the student? Masawat. What is masawat in preamble?
Equality.
Very good. So it's equality in which language? Yes, Jenny.
Urdu.
Urdu.
Very good. Very good. Very good. It's equality in Urdu. Bingo. Now the next question is, what is Matetra? Matetra in which language? Anyone? Anyone can answer Matetra?
It's in Malayalam, maybe.
Yes, yes, Jenny, you're absolutely right. Bingo. But what does that mean?
Matetra. I have no idea about the meaning, but I know the word is Malayali.
Yeah, that's true. That's correct. So Jenny, you win the point, but anyone can tell me what does that mean?
Matetra means secular.
Disha, you're right. Absolutely correct. Bingo. So Disha won this. Now the next question, fast was. Next question, Uddeshika. What do you mean by Uddeshika?
Goal?
Yeah, but what does that
motive.
Mean? It means
yeah,
preamble.
Yeah, absolutely. It's preamble. Bingo. Preamble. In which language? Can you tell me the language as well?
The language would be Sanskrit.
No.
Deshika.
Hindi.
Hindi.
It's anyone else? Come on, guys, give the answer. Deshika.
Marathi.
Bingo, absolutely right. Okay, fine. So the last question, Banduta. Banduta.
Brotherhood.
Unity. Ananya, you're saying something? Ananya, Jenny?
Brotherhood.
Fraternity. Jinsi, you're absolutely right. In which language?
Gujarati. Nepali.
No.
Gujarati.
Nepali.
It's in Sanskrit.
Gujarati. I'm sure of Gujarati.
Yes. Jinsi is right. The answer is fraternity in Gujarati. Okay, fine. So we are done with the rapid fire round. Now I would like to request Professor Uma Mahesh Satyanarayan, our advisor, UWSL, to deliver a vote of thanks.
Very, very good evening, one and all present here. It's my pleasure to have Professor Nishtha Jaiswal Imam sir, and my association with Professor Nishtha Jaiswal has been for more than a decade now. And the first name I could think of having as chief guest for the event, especially an occasion like Law Day, I could think of none other than Professor Nishtha Jaiswal, an erudite scholar and a humble human being. And I would just tell a student like how my first interaction has been with her. I think one of my moots while I was in fifth year was adjudicated by Dr. Nishtha Jaiswal, along with judges of the Supreme Court and High Court. And this is very fresh in my memory, even till date. It's been almost like 11 years now. She was adjudicating a moot on a constitutional proposition, where she was asking certain questions from the bench. And the kind of questions she was posing, even the sitting judges of the Supreme Court and High Court were not aware of. And we could very clearly see they were asking her for, like, you know, some kind of an assistance. And finally, I could see the Supreme Court judge ended up saying, please, you mark, we are not going to mark this round. So I think she ended up marking for us. So I think the kind of acumen that she has, and I think today's session was very enlightening, especially in terms of how she gave the entire constitution in a nutshell. And I think it's a very difficult job, if you can understand, talking constitution right from 1951 till date. And I think she took two parallel references, which I should really appreciate her of. One is she started talking to us about each and every amendment. Parallelly, she also spoke about the developments that took place in terms of the judiciary and how judiciary came up each time with a possible interpretation of the law. I think that parallel is very important for student of law to understand. And I think from Goloknath till Babita Punia, she's covered the wide range of cases the Supreme Court has come up with, all possible interpretations of constitutional provisions. I think this is something which is very appreciable, ma'am. And we look forward to having you here. And I think our students are keen to have more and more of constitutional sessions, law sessions with you. I think this is a start. We would always want this association to continue. I think somewhere we're looking for the start. And I think nothing like having you on a Constitution Day. And it's a pleasure. And we would always look forward to having you on board, ma'am, for our future endeavor.
Thank you, Vita. Would be my pleasure. God bless all of you. God bless, Vita. God bless.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
And I would really want to thank all the students who participated today. I'm quite thankful to Dr. Nishtha Jaiswal and definitely our president, Sri Hitesh Adati, who's given us all this opportunity. And I think without my students, this event wouldn't have been a success. And I'm really proud with such short notice, you guys coming up with 11 languages of preamble. That is something which I would not have done personally if I would have been a student. I really appreciate and thank you all for this presence. Keep the spirit up. And this is where you're going to show that we are not less than any law school, which some of you kept telling me in the first instance. Sir, you could see your potentials yourself. Given a time, within short span of probably 2 hours, you could put up such a good show. That means it's individual potential that matters and nothing beyond that. Please keep up the spirit. All the very best, and I look forward to meeting you all later. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Professor. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.